What one critic has called the performance of his lifetime, Weeds. This month on HBO, the best movies.
The following movie has been rated R by the Motion Picture Association of America. This indicates that it contains material of an adult nature. Parents may wish to consider whether it should be viewed by children under 17. For further information, please consult your program guide.
You want to talk about the vanishing wilderness?
Louis, listen, what are you so...
Intrigue and suspense in a thriller from Manila. An ex-cop moves from hot climate to scorching action in his search for a kidnapped victim. Sloan is on the case, next on HBO. Choice next on Cinemax. Dom DeLuise is obsessed with food until a pretty blonde turns his head. There's plenty of Cinemania in Fatso. Next. The following movie has been rated PG by the Motion Picture Association of America. Parental guidance is suggested. Choice next on Cinemax. John Huston and George C. Scott star in the greatest story ever told, The Bible in the Beginning. Next.
And Olivia de Havilland, Buell Brenner, even Ronald Reagan.
Wow, the president, a cowboy?
Yeah, Western movies may be fewer today, but they'll never fade out.
You fell on one side of the fence and I fell on the other, and it's too late to argue about it now.
Gee, Dad, now I'd really love to see one with you.
Good. We'll watch the roundup of great westerns on Cinemax together all this month.
Riding on the range. I've got my hat on. I've got my boots. Dusky. I wanna be a cowboy. And you can be my cowgirl.
Western Roundup. Just one of the ways Cinemax gives you more movies, more choice. The following movie has been rated R by the Motion Picture Association of America. It is intended for mature audiences. Parents may wish to consider whether it should be viewed by children under 17.
Thank you.
More movies, more choice. Next on Cinemax. Van Heflin's a family man. Glenn Ford's a murderer. They're both catching the 310 to Yuma. Next from Western Roundup. Cinemax in November. Remember, it means more movies, more choice.
They want fatal beauty!
Yeah!
There's a new kind of death on the streets. It kills those who take it. It means death for those who inform.
You know, everywhere I go, people are dying to meet me.
Whoopi Goldberg stars in the Cinemax exclusive premiere, Fatal Beauty. Then whoop it up with three more movies starring Whoopi. She's learning to spy in Jumpin' Jack Flash.
Yes, I'm winging it,
Marty. Oh, that's great.
Well, thank you.
She's an Oscar nominee for The Color Purple. And she's a knockout in Burglar. The mob knows this woman's a witness.
You're gonna find your dead with your face missing.
That's tough for a classy lady. It's tougher for a working class cop.
I'm on duty.
What kind of duty? Gigolo?
Tom Berenger, Mimi Rogers, someone to watch over me. Jimi Hendrix, his guitar electrified the 60s. His showmanship blew them away. Now Cinemax brings you the never-before-seen footage of the 1967 vintage performance at Monterey that made Jimi Hendrix a star.
Bed, sleep, touch, struggle, not to
work. From the heart, pulses with the star power of Barbara Streisand, Sylvester Stallone, and Henry Winkler. A mix and match of Wood, Culp, Gould, and Cannon. The captive hearts of Pat Morita and Christopher Makepeace. And the racing heart of Richard Pryor. Then,
yes, cerebral palsy, and that doesn't affect your intelligence.
A courageous struggle to make a place in the world. The Cinemax film discovery, Gabi, a true story.
It's all right, sir. It's not loaded.
Donald Sutherland, secret agent and bumbler. He's tracking down a Soviet truth serum, and the truth is, he hasn't a clue.
I'm not doing very well.
That's The Trouble with Spies on Cinemania. Next, thrillers. Beau Bridges and Kiefer Sutherland kill time. A maniac stalks Diane Lane in Lady Beware. Honest cop Fred McMurray is a pushover for Kim Novak. And there's strong suspicion Anthony Andrews is going to kill Jane Curtin. They definitely need intellectual stimulation.
Give them brains.
Return of the Living Dead 2. And coming in December, the Kubrick Festival blasts off with Full Metal Jacket, and the doors open wide for a mind-blowing vintage performance. Meanwhile, on November 19th, Jimi Hendrix plays at Monterey, and Whoopi Goldberg stars in Fatal Beauty. And don't miss a whole night of Whoopi on the 21st. Cinemax in November. More movies, more choice.
Screen star Kevin Costner leads the way in the new murder mystery, No Way Out. Costner plays Lieutenant Commander Tom Farrell, whose special assignment is to act as the liaison between the Secretary of Defense and the notorious CIA.
He's a man with a lot of secrets. And he, in the course of this movie, he finds himself amongst very powerful people, the most powerful people in the government, and some incidents happen, and they're going to take him down. And it's very sad, but it's very reasonable to think that, yeah, he's the person that's going to go. And the movie just manipulates itself so that they're just dragging this guy down under.
Those powerful figures that Lieutenant Commander Farrell finds himself up against are considered to be some of Washington's top officials.
There's the Secretary of Defense, Gene Hackman, and his right-hand man, Will Patton, Scott Pritchard, and they're both powerful, and they know how to use their power. And the point of the movie is that you realize that they're willing to do anything to keep it going.
Well, if we go looking for a Russian spy without the FBI or the CIA in on it, it's going to raise hell.
That's my problem.
They have this gigantic machinery behind them that they feel like they can do anything. Just the picking up the phone call, they can make things happen.
The man we're after is a spy and a murderer. Would anyone deny that justice had been done?
Yeah, I would.
Well, we shall have that discussion at the appropriate time. But for now, I expect you to follow direct orders, and I expect you to demonstrate the personal loyalty to which both the Secretary and I have every right.
You expect a lot.
The central theme of No Way Out is one of political and personal intrigue inside the Pentagon. The film's plot has a certain ring of truth to it.
My notion when I read the script over a year ago was that it was very true. You know, I always start that way with a script, that if you can believe it. I mean, movies always require a leap of faith anyway. That's what can make them theatrical. And to my way of thinking, the political arena is something I don't know a lot about. But the language made sense to me, and it immediately put me into Washington, and I believe the characters, I believe what they were saying, and I believe that there was real drama.
Also starring in No Way Out is Gene Hackman, who plays David Bryce, the overly ambitious Secretary of Defense. Hackman's portrayal of Bryce is a perfect example of a consummate politician played by an expert actor.
I just really think he's as good as we have to offer as an actor. I don't know what I learned from him other than I wish that there's certain qualities he has that I wish that I had. But maybe that's the highest compliment.
Besides sharing the screen, Costner and Hackman also share a love interest, a young Washington party girl, Susan Atwell. Played by Sean Young, Atwell has a close encounter with Lieutenant Commander Farrell.
I've seen love scenes done, and I've seen them done well, and I've seen them done badly. And this one was real time. I mean, it begins with me seeing her, and it begins with me, and I undress her, and I do everything all, you know, in one take. It's not, you know, there's no pieces, there's no trick photography in what's going on, and so it was difficult that way.
Going even one step further, for the sake of realism, Costner insists on performing his own stunt.
The nature of my acting is physical. I think people know subconsciously when the camera pulls back and it's a stuntman. I don't think you say out loud, gee, that's a stuntman. But, you know, movies work on your subconscious level, too. And you know that when it pulls back, it's somebody else. But when the camera's right in there, you know it's me.
Although he relies on his own intuition, Costner also acknowledges the value of an inventive director.
I think I'm directable. I come in with a really strong point of view when it comes to a movie. I don't do a movie unless I have a strong point of view about it. So if nobody has an idea about what's going on, I do. But I like direction. I like directors that, you know, that have ideas. So I'm kind of like a Cadillac. You can drive me and parallel park me, but you got to treat me good, too.
This month on Cinemax. More movies, more choice. Next on Cinemax. Van Heflin's a family man, Glenn Ford's a murderer. They're both catching the 310 to Yuma. Next from Western Roundup.
All this month, they're coming by land, by sea, and in the air.
And they're coming in force.
Five forceful tales of war from the dispatches of Military Max.
Ready, Army?
Ready, Navy!
Get ready for the inspirational true story of Navy ace Frank Spig Weed, John Wayne, the Wings of Eagles. Then, an all-star cast goes behind enemy lines in an Academy Award-winning classic,
Fire!
The Guns of Navarone.
You love to drop bombs, smash cities, kill.
That's war.
Steve McQueen's riding the edge between heroism and psychosis in The War Lover. And a couple of war lovers.
What are you going to do after the war, Case?
A dangerous mission. A daring commander hell-bent on winning. Ronald Reagan, Hellcats of the Navy. And one hell of a cat who's proud to claim the title of United States Marine, Clint Eastwood.
Our Great Ridge.
You ready to take over, Max?
Military Max. Ready and able all this month on Cinemax, where you get more movies and more choice.
I think war's just been declared.
This here's the story of the western town of Progress. It's got its good side and its bad side. Take Marshall Flagg. He's a good guy.
This office Marshall this side of the Mississippi.
That's Big John McKay. He's a bad guy.
John McKay is one of the most wanted outlaws in the country.
Mayor Wilker's a good guy, and so is Carmel. But put them together and they're bad. Then there's Waco, who seems like a good guy.
Thanks. I believe in law and order.
But he's bad. So is he. So is he. All of them have come to this good town with bad intentions. So bad that bad guy John McKay's decided to turn good.
Do I have your word this time?
You got it. How's it turn out? Catch Robert Mitchum, George Kennedy, Martin Balsam, Tina Louise, and David Carradine in a wacky comedy western, The Good Guys and the Bad Guys.
Riding on the range, I've got my hat on, I've got my boots dusty, I've got my saddle,
Roundup. Just one of the ways Cinemax gives you more movies, more choice.
Pop, why is it that folks love Western movies so much?
Well, mostly because they keep alive an era in our history that's gone.
So what was the Wild West like?
Well, they were hard times, really, wrestled to life by hardy people. The heroes were all larger than life. And the villains all deserve whatever they got.
But right here in Texas, we've got the greatest gunslingers there are.
You know, Dad, I miss all gunfighters' robots, so no one could kill them ever.
A nice twist of legend, son, but already shot.
Draw. Oh, my God.
Have a lot of big stars filled those western skies?
Yeah. Steve McQueen, Linda Evans, Errol Flynn, William Holden, Glenn Ford, Olivia de Havilland, Yul Brynner, even Ronald Reagan.
Wow, the president, a cowboy?
Yeah, Western movies may be fewer today, but they'll never fade out.
You fell on one side of the fence and I fell on the other, and it's too late to argue about it now.
Gee, Dad, now I'd really love to see one with you.
Good, we'll watch the roundup of great Westerns on Cinemax together, all this month.
Train called at 310 to Yuma.